What's up, YouTube? Today I want to talk about something, and it started with the Army has a new fitness program or test if you want to switch over to combat arms. And I'm prior service Army, and I never did like much of the tests. But anyway, it was about women in combat making a test. If they pass it, one size fits all, they can do combat. And I keep coming back to this question. Now, I grew up in a home. My mom was an entrepreneur. I have no problem with women getting out there and doing awesome things. But sometimes our society jumps at things because it sounds good. The news, the way they spin it, it sounds good. I feel like they're missing certain points that are important. I like to analyze people. One of the books I read is military based. It's from a retired Ranger, Colonel Grossman. And he has a book on combat and on killing. And they found that after an adrenaline moment after a gunfight, but like 80% of the men had to have sex that night, and 20% closed up and wanted some alone time because of the traumatic event. When you're putting women in combat arms, this is a topic that hasn't even scratched the surface. You're introducing women into this. And so I posted a comment on this, and this girl's like, "You need to control yourself." Basically said it was a lack of self-discipline and I was the one who needed help. Anyway, like whatever. I'm just bringing up the statistics of it after a gunfight. And it's the same reason after a mission, even though some of the events are unknown, you go out on mission, you come back and you're wired and pumped. You go to the gym to wind down. You need to release, you know, or to burn it off. So we kind of know, you know, that there's an energy there. I mean, you come in at 2 a.m. and you're like, "Dude, I need to wind down. I'm wired because life and death situation." Anyway, you add a woman to that, and now, you know, you can get the release sexually. I guess all I'm saying is there are things that haven't been discussed, haven't been addressed. And so if you want women in combat, these women need to know what they're up against. I mean, a lot of guys are gonna have self-control, but I'm telling you, there are some men that just, there's a woman, I need a release. Even if it's not like aggressive abuse, they'd be like, "Hey baby," you know, she's gonna be put in awkward situation. The other aspect that I thought was interesting is when women are shot, there's this idea that we're all the same, everyone equal rights, equal this, equal that, and it's a load of crap. We are not the same. We are different, even in the same group, you know, of just all men or all women. People have unique talents and traits and whatever. There's some men that shouldn't be police officers, you know what I'm saying? Like, so when a woman turns into pink mist or she's shot up, there's a higher percentage of men that just stop fighting. It's like my role as a protector failed and they shut down. I don't know what it is, it just statistically, that's what happens. You want to add women to combat roles and, you know, kick down doors and shoot up the place, you're also adding the chance that men won't return fire and will shut down, focus on other tasks because of this biological thing that we have. And you can be like, "Oh no, we can train that out of you." Go ahead and try. You know, go ahead and try to train it out of them. But to a certain extent, not everything can be 100% brainwashed and conditioned. You know, it's there. We need to be aware of the psychological effects. And sometimes we disregard that due to the political arena of what's trendy to say and what's trendy to do. It's put out there on this global platform and everybody responds and takes a side. But we need to step back and look at it openly. I have no problem with either side. I just think, hey, we need to look at this from some angles we haven't looked at and address them. Just by bringing this up, you know, I'm gonna get some haters from it because they're like, "Oh, you're anti-women or whatever." I'm not anti-women, I have no problem. If you're a woman jumping into combat arms, no, your sexual harassment is gonna increase. Know that men, after an adrenaline moment, are gonna look for a sexual release. Statistically, it's there. If you made it equal across the board and put men and women in combat and shoot them up and let women get shot and turn into pink mist, that you would see a decrease in performance and efficiency. That would be my hunch. I could be totally wrong, but that would be my hunch based on women being shot and injured. Statistically, that is the number from the evidence that we have so far. Compound that with an increase in a possibility of increase of sexual harassment, rape, assault, not wise. But I think women should be informed of that, and if they still want to, you know, pursue that, they all the power to you. It's not my choice. The government lays all that out for you. You know, you pass the test, pass go, collect your $200 and join Combat Arms. If I was in business and I knew there was a chance that by adding females into the ranks, it would decrease performance, ability to accomplish the mission, as a businessman, I'd be like, whoa, let's look at some more numbers. Let's figure this out. If it was me, I'd make an all-women's team and they can all go nuts. And if I saw 12 crazy women coming at me, I'd be like, I'm going to die. I paid my dues. I broke my back. You know, I've seen just a little bit. So take that for what it's worth. All right. I'm going to share with you a little secret. And this won't be popular either. Sorry, ladies. Hate to throw you under the bus here. But as I analyze people, well, we know that 1 in 4, 1 in 5 women have been abused. They kind of know that. From what I can tell, from what I've analyzed and read and done my little research, for whatever it's worth and however accurate it is, from my opinion, that number's like 80-85% of women in police roles, military, have been abused. I've been trying to figure out why. And so my assumption is that if you're a woman and you've been a victim, you've been abused, taken advantage of in whatever form, physical, sexually, whatever, that your reason for joining the police and military is probably more about, I don't want to be a victim anymore. I want to take control and I'm going to learn to defend myself. And so they join these ranks to teach them how to fight, how to do that. So just because they show you how to use a gun and show you how to tackle somebody, emotionally and personally, you still have been a victim. I think it's their way of trying to overcome this victim person. I'm just putting it out there from the evidence that I have seen. I've analyzed a lot of people, and people would bring people to me to analyze just because I have a knack for it. I'd be like, hey, you've been abused. They're like, how do you know that? I'm like, hey, you've been raped. How do you know that? I'm like, I just read people. I can read the tea leaves and by what people do, certain traits. But I could sit there and be like, man, I'm like, hey, you have an abuse trait. What's going on? And they'd be like, hey. And they would be like, and I was like, man, I analyzed, you know, 50 women and 45 of them have been abused. I'm like, what is the deal in the military? You know, what's going on? So the evidence I'm basing it off of is me analyzing these people. And some of them would open up. You know, they'd be like, yeah, something happened when I was 13. Something happened. This happened to me. This happened to me. And I was like, wow, I'm not your shrink. I just profile and I see these things. I see the scars that are left there. I don't know the story, but I'm putting it out there just so you're aware. There's also a bigger picture at play in this. Very long-winded. I'm out. All right, until next time.